Learn how to edit layers in ArcGIS Pro using different techniques. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button below, if you haven't done so already. So today we continue our ArcGIS Pro series and we'll be doing some quick editing with the trace tool and the direction and distance function. In my last tutorial, I created projects, added connections, and got started with some editing. So you can check that out at the top of this video right now. Anyhow, let's get into today's topic. So we launch ArcGIS Pro and open our map to be edited. I already have my layers added to this map. Adding layers here in ArcGIS Pro is done in the same way you add layers to a map in ArcMap. Remember, you can also import existing MXD files into your ArcGIS Pro project. Check out my video about ArcMap versus ArcGIS Pro for more information. I'll link it at the top of this video and at the end of this tutorial. Once opened and all layers added, you need to select the Edit tab at the top of the screen and then select Edit. We will use the trace feature first, and just a note, this is also available in ArcMap on the editor toolbar, and tracing is done the same way we are about to do it here as it is done in ArcMap. In my scenario, I want to add an area that will later be used for zoning. A part of this boundary intersects my roads layer, so I will draw a new area by tracing the roads layer. I select the area feature template in the create window and select the trace tool. So we need to click at our starting point and the line that you want to trace and just draw your mouse along the road layer to trace. And where the direction changes in the road layer, I would recommend clicking at those changes as I do here. You can also draw your features using right angles. I will draw another area and trace the roads layer again. Be careful when tracing features, as you could unintentionally trace over features you didn't intend to, like in my case. Now that we have our new area feature, I need to add a new proposed road by plotting this road with directions and distances received. So I select the road feature template to edit and select my starting point. At my starting point, I right click on my mouse and select direction / distance. You have different options here to determine your direction. So think about the cardinal points north, south, east, west. For our default option, we have quadrant bearing, QB, which is pretty much directions in the different quadrants, meaning it's in the northeast quadrant, northwest, southeast, southwest. You can also use a north azimuth for direction, meaning that you measure the azimuth from 0 to 360 degrees, with 0 being north or at the northernmost cardinal point. And conversely, you have the south azimuth, which is the same as north, except that the 0 starts at the southern cardinal point. You can also provide directions using the polar angles, which is pretty much like north and south azimuth, except that 0 starts at the easternmost cardinal point. And I think this is what is used in ArcMap, because I've had to convert bearings to whatever direction format ArcMap uses, and the polar angle seems to fit best with this. You can comment below to let me know otherwise. Anyhow, as you can see, I use the quadrant bearing direction and I enter my bearing. I also enter my distance, but I change the units of measurement. I completed a second vertex. Once done, or even as you go along, you can save your edits. That's very important. So today, we edited using the trace tool and we use the direction and distance function. In the next ArcGIS Pro tutorial, we get started with displaying data by symbolizing and labeling. As usual, thank you so much for watching and please don't forget to like, subscribe and share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorial. or if you have other tutorials that you'd like to see. Thanks again and see you next time.